What's the common thing between this Nintendo console, this smartphone, and this personal computer from 1992? They all run on the ARM architecture, a 32-bit architecture that's low power, low cost, and very fast. With over 100 billion ARM processors produced as of January 2017, ARM can be found in just about every mobile, handheld, and smart TV device today. But where did ARM originate? To answer that, we need to go back to 1987 and take a detailed look at one of the first ARM computers. In the late 80s, riding high on the success of the BBC Micro, Acorn Computers Limited in England released the first general-purpose computer based on its architecture that they dubbed Acorn RISC Machine, or ARM. This computer was called the Acorn Archimedes, and as we know, this architecture is widely used in just about every single embedded and mobile device today. Like the BBC Micro before it, this 32-bit computer was targeted toward education and schools. The A3000 series range of computers were the first ARM-based computers that had a single-part case design that both the Amiga and Atari ST utilized as well. I was lucky enough to get my hands on an Acorn Archimedes A3010. This machine was geared for the home computing market and games, rather than for the classroom, and it has the features to back it up. Let's take a look. The A3010 comes with a very distinctive keyboard with green function keys. This is in contrast to the red function keys of the Acorn A3000 computer and BBC Micro. It features 1 MB of RAM out of the box, and on the right hand side contains a floppy disk drive, capable of reading high density disks up to 1.6 MB in size. On the left side of the case is a standard reset switch, which is something that the Atari ST also came with. On the back of the unit contains a power on-off switch. It requires 220 volts AC from the wall. The A3010 is the only Archimedes computer that contains a TV modulator connector. To the left of that is a standard video VGA RGB output. Next is the standard headphone jack. Then we have a mouse connector, and again unique to the A3010, two standard 9-pin joystick ports. Finally, an RS-232 serial port rounds out the connectors at the back.
So as you can see, this particular machine was competing directly with the Atari ST and the Amiga. It had the same all-in-one computer design with the built-in keyboard and floppy disk and power supply. But we're going to go ahead and open up the machine and see what's inside it and see what makes this particular machine different from the 16-bit Motorola computers.
Opening the machine is fairly trivial. Just use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove the 3 screws at the bottom of the case. Flip the machine back upright and you will notice that the case is held together using plastic tabs. This is similar to an Xbox 360 case. Simply pushing the plastic tab will allow the top portion to be detached from the bottom portion of the case. Work your way across and the top portion will simply lift away. Next, we will need to remove the keyboard. There are 2 plastic ribbon connectors attached to the motherboard. Gently removing these will allow the keyboard to be safely lifted away. The A3010 comes with a built-in speaker, which is a very handy addition. And in order to remove the metallic shielding, use a Torx screwdriver to remove the screws at the base of the shielding. I suspect there may be more screws normally, but mine are missing. Once that's done, the shielding can be removed. Just make sure that you disconnect the floppy drive power and speaker connectors as well. So let's take a look at the motherboard. Starting on the right are the RAM chips. The Archimedes A3010 usually has 1 MB on board, but this unit has a 4 MB RAM expansion installed. The 2 chips next to those are for the operating system called RISC OS. Like the Atari ST, this OS is built into the ROM chips and does not need a disk in the drive to boot from. In fact, the Archimedes computer will always boot to RISC OS even if you leave a floppy disk in the drive. The CPU is known as the ARM250, which is a 32-bit RISC processor that runs at 12 MHz. The original ARM2 CPU found in the Archimedes A3000 computer ran at 8 MHz. The TV modulator provides the ability to connect up the A3010 to a standard TV, and on the right we see that the power supply is built into the case as shown by the large transformer. The CMOS battery holds all the settings including the time and RISC OS preferences and the screen mode that you selected. These batteries are notorious for leaking, so keep checking them every so often and replace them at the first sign of trouble. But you may be asking, where are the graphics and sound chips on the motherboard? Well, the ARM250 also houses both of those in addition to the I/O and memory controller chips. This is truly the first system-on-a-chip, or SoC, that is common in many devices today. The ARM250 runs at around 7 MIPS, or millions of instructions per second, which, if you compare, is roughly equivalent to an Amiga 1200 with a 68030 processor running at around 33 MHz. Out of the box, this translates to the A3010 providing far superior processing power. However, the Amiga had its custom chips, and with good coding, can outperform the A3010. So, technical specifications aside, how well does this computer perform, and what are the games like? Booting up the machine will launch you directly into RISC OS. This is a very nice user interface with excellent built-in applications. RISC OS is a multitasking operating system as seen by my example here of formatting a floppy disk while utilizing an inbuilt paint program. The keyboard is very nice quality, much better than the spongy Atari ST keyboard, and has a satisfying click with each key press. The speaker is also a nice touch. It doesn't sound amazing or anything, but it gets the job done. Take a listen. Alright, so you're probably wondering, what about the games? Well, many of the games were Amiga ports, but most of them were very good ports taking advantage of the Archimedes 256 colors on screen and 8-channel sound. Here are some examples of excellent ports from the Amiga. The Archimedes also had many custom games for the system as well as some excellent ports. Here's a sample of a few. Now, one piece of advice I want to give to everyone is, if you're looking to buy an Acorn Archimedes computer, make sure you get a mouse with it. If you don't have a mouse with this computer, it's basically a dead weight. You can't really do much without a mouse, unfortunately. This system doesn't actually boot off floppy disks at all. Every time you power on the machine, even with a disk inserted, it's going to boot to RISC OS, and the only way to actually access the disk drive is using a mouse. Now, of course, there could be some keyboard shortcuts, but a mouse is essential to use this machine. And unfortunately, the price of an Acorn Archimedes mouse out there on eBay and other resellers is very expensive. In some cases, it's even more expensive than the computer itself. So keep that in mind. Your best option is to find a package where a particular seller is selling the computer and the mouse as well. But once you have the mouse, you have pretty much everything you need to go ahead and use this amazing piece of hardware. And finally, there are some handy tools online available to create your own floppy disks from disk images out there. This tool is one particular example called OmniDisk. It's a simple command line tool. You will need a Windows PC with a floppy disk drive. Unfortunately, a USB floppy disk drive won't work.
Guys, let me know what you thought about the Acorn Archimedes 3010 home computer. As always, don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe if you like my channel, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye for now.